safety measures to protect yourself from this virus, as you know that again this virus and the death tolls and the infection tolls, they are increasing. Kunal, welcome to the class. So good afternoon to you and Shubho Vijaya again. So as I was telling, that I think that you have taken the proper measures to spend these holidays, right? Okay, so as the holidays are over, now some important discussions before I start today's class. Yes, Sanjeevani, I'll definitely give you the syllabus of your half yearly examination. So be ready with the book. Okay, so as you know already that you are going to have the half yearly examination. I don't know the dates. The dates will be notified to you through the e-portal or through the website. Okay, so it's my suggestions that as you visit the website for next day's class, also visit it regularly for checking the dates. Kunal, it's most probably it's in this month, that means in November. In November it will start the half yearly, and the syllabus is chapter number 2, that is the writing and the city life. Okay, chapter number 2, that is writing and the city life. Then chapter number 3, an empire across the 3 continents. Then chapter number 4, the central Islamic lands. Then chapter number 6, the 3 orders. And chapter number 7, changing cultural traditions. So you are going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 chapters. Okay, you are going to have 5 chapters, that is let me just type the chapter name. Chapter 1, not 1, sorry, chapter 2, comma, chapter 3, comma, chapter 4, comma, chapter 6, comma, chapter 7. Okay, that means we are going to deal with Mesopotamia, then the Roman Empire, then Islamic lands, then you have 3 orders, then you have Renaissance. Okay, Mesopotamia chapter 2, Roman Empire chapter 3, Islamic lands chapter 4, 3 orders chapter 6, and Renaissance, that is the changing cultural traditions, that is chapter 7. Okay, so these 5 chapters will be there, and you are going to have MCQ questions, you are going to have multiple choice questions, 50 marks, like you have faced it in 20 marks last time. This year, this time you are going to face 50 marks MCQ questions. So it's a request, it's a suggestion that all of you should read the chapters line by line. No theories are going to come for this. No. How much time means the exam time, Kunal? You are asking me the exam time. information is not there in your syllabus, Riddha. Yes, chapter 9 is Industrial Revolution. That is complete, I know. But I think I have started the chapter 10, Displacing Indigenous People. Just check it. The natives, North American natives. Yes, I have started. Encounters with the Europeans. I think this I have not done. Mutual perception and all. That I have not done. Right. Okay. So today we will start, whether I have done it or not. I have only two chapters. So I can be at the leisure that I can repeat it. So I'll start today about the encounters with Europeans. Okay. So what this chapter is about, this is that in this chapter we are going to study two continents. One is North America and another is these two continents. What happened that from a long time indigenous people used to live in these lands, and when these indigenous people used to live in these lands, the countries were not named, the continent was not named as North America or Australia. It was after the 15th century, during the 16th, 17th century, after the Renaissance period, it was during that time that a bunch of European people, they went to North America first, then they went to Australia, and they made North America and Australia their colonies. First of all, these two countries or continents served as colonies. But then, slowly, they started killing, started displacing the indigenous people of this particular country, or this particular continent. And there was a time came that the number of indigenous people, the number of original aborigines, the original inhabitants of this particular landmass became less or negative. So this white-skinned European people became the one and only residents of these two continents. And slowly they realized that they have done something wrong. They have not given the proper human rights to these original aborigines. So after they have done a lot of crime, they started providing these few people who were left some privileges, some advantages to live in their country and to be a part of their new European style of living. Okay, so this is the main story which we are going to study in this chapter. So I have started the chapter and I have talked about the North America, the condition of North America, how was the condition, the geographical features, and the people who used to live there, how they look, what were their languages, I have discussed. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about that. In the 17th century, the European traders, they came to North America, okay? So that means before the 17th century, no person craft unique to a tribe or food items not available in other region. So what they saw that the French people or the European people, English people, they saw that these natives, they gather at one day, one particular day in a week beside the Mississippi River, and they exchange different type of goods. They exchange different ornaments, they exchange different type of food items, they exchange different type of dress materials and many things. And that means the exchange means there was no economical system, there was no money system, there was no coin system, there was a system was barter system. That means you give me potatoes, I give you onion. You give me a woven scarf, I give you two bangles, which is a handmade handicraft. Okay? Then, in exchange for local products, the Europeans gave the native blankets, iron vessels, guns, which was a useful supplement to for bows and arrows to kill animals, and alcohol. So the Europeans, they, as I told you, that they first came as to make colonies. So in a colony, first thing you do is to trade. So when the Europeans, they came, they saw that these people, they don't take money, they take product. So they had to give some product to the natives to buy the native products. Okay, so in buying through exchange of the native products, they used to provide iron tools, guns, gunmen, rifles to kill animals, hunt for hunting. They also used to give blankets to cover themselves at night, and also provided alcohol. And they used to get beautiful bangles, scarves, beautiful vessels, different food items, and these things, what they used to get, and then they used to sell them back in the market of Europe. So this was a barter system, that from Europe they brought iron tools, iron vessels, alcohol, guns, and several other things, and in exchange they used to take scarves, dress material, bangles, other jewelries, and food items. Okay? Yes. So this is how the Europeans, they entered, but the problem was different kind. The problem was that these natives